Jesus. We magnify the Lord. God, even as we are standing, God, let no one ever fall from your grace, O Lord. Let no one fall from your grace, O Jehovah. And Lord Almighty Jesus Christ, may you fortify these walls around us, O Jehovah, in the name of Jesus Christ. We give you praise and honor, Jehovah. We have a firm stand in you, Jesus. And even as we come before you boldly, and we thank you because this stand is established in you, Jesus. The exalted Redeemer, the magnified Redeemer. Thank you, precious God. And so also let us enter a moment of thanksgiving. Let us just thank God for the session that we've had. Let us thank God for the answered prayers. Let us thank God for everything that he has done for us. Let us thank God for every foundation that is being broken. Let us thank God for his light and his glory that has risen upon us. God, we thank you, Jehovah. We bless you, name Jesus, for every answered prayers, Jehovah. We thank you and we give you praise, Redeemer. There is no one else like you, Jesus. You are great, O Lord. God Almighty, we thank you, Lord. Thank you for every evil foundation that is broken. Thank you because you have restored our relationship with you, Jehovah. Thank you, Jehovah, because your light is strong upon us, Lord. We bless your name, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We honor you, Jesus. Thank you. Jesus' mighty name, we pray and believe.
Open your mouth and tell him he's worth it. To receive glory, to receive praise, to receive honor. Just open your mouth and adore him. Don't be silent. His presence. To see him glorified. Take that step, Lord. Know your way. I'm just a vessel, nothing more. Bye.
We are. Yeah. Yeah. You raided. We bless your name, Lord. You reign in this place. You reign in our lives. You reign in our hearts. You reign in everything that we do. You reign, oh Lord. You reign, you reign, you reign, you reign, you reign, you reign, you reign. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I feel the power of the Holy Spirit in this house today. And the Lord God Almighty is going to do big, big things in our lives this wonderful evening. Hallelujah. If you believe that, say amen. If you believe it, say amen. If you believe it, say amen. Every plant that God has not planted, this is a season that it must be uprooted. Amen. Every tradition that is not of God, it must bow down. Every definition of anything that doesn't comply to the dictates of the kingdom must bow down. Hallelujah. Every experience that is not of the kingdom, this evening, it must bow down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This conference, Ignite Conference, is just the beginning of many, many, many great things in the life of this church. Amen. Mambo mengi yanaenda kutendeka. Misingi ambazo sio za kiungu zinaenda kuvunjika. Wale ambao wamefungwa wanaenda kufunguliwa na kukombolewa katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Ili kwamba kanisa la Buruburu liende likamtumikie Mwenyezi Mungu. Hallelujah. There is great potential in our lives and we must be released. Yesterday, when I arrived in my house, I felt that great things had happened here. And I really felt it. You know, I was sharing with the man of God the experiences that I went through. He shocked me by telling me that he went through the same experiences. And this confirmed to me that jana ngome zilianguka. Na hata leo, come on, patia Yesu makofi mazuri. Amen. Hata leo, ngome zinaenda fanya nini? Kuanguka. Amen. I want to recognize the presence of the Friends Fellowship Assembly who are here wapigiwe makofi. The vessels of honor who are here wapigiwe makofi. I've seen a member from the Gethsemane Ministries apigiwe makofi. The Church of God Buruburu leadership ambao wako hapa wapatiwe makofi. Na sisi sote ambao tumefika katika kongamano hili tupigiwe makofi. Today we are doing day two of the Ignite Conference with the theme, Let My People Go. And if you are seated there and you are wishing in your heart that this is the season, indeed you are going to receive it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are going to do what? To receive it. Tell your neighbor, fire upon fire. Again, fire upon fire. Say it again, fire upon fire. Hey, sisi hapa ni ile Church of God ya kitambo. Amen. Usimame. With all humility, I will request that we put our hands together as the servant of God, Reverend Gilbert Odhiambo, comes to minister this wonderful evening. Makofi mazuri, makofi ya shangwe. Makofi ya shangwe, makofi ya shangwe. Makofi ya shangwe, makofi ya shangwe. Makofi ya shangwe, makofi ya shangwe. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Father, we soak your servant in the blood of Jesus. And we pray that the anointing from above will flow. That your children would be revived and touched and uplifted to the glory of Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord, as we decrease, let your spirit increase through this ministration of the word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
I want to thank you all again for coming. I want to thank you for accepting. You know, when you come, it means that you are honoring the man of God and the people that organize this. And so we thank God that you are honoring them, because when you honor them, God that led them to do this will also bless you. Bwana asifiwe. And so the anointing that you don't honor will not be a blessing to you in any way. Hata kama nakupea mpaka nakuruka. So we want to thank God for you. And I want you just to be seated shortly before we go to the next thing that I want to do. Praise the Lord. The man of God has prayed. Praise the Lord. I feel strongly, this is what I feel, that we need to begin with before we go to the word for today. What I want to share with you is that there are people who have come today and the Lord is telling me, you've come and you are heavier than the normal weight that you carry. You're feeling like unabebewa. You are being, somebody is hanging on your back. Somebody, and you're feeling weights over your shoulder. Somebody's feeling like something is holding your neck. Somebody has some part of your stomach. It's like something is inside. And you have such kind of a thing. The other person is feeling like your right eye is paining. And it's like there's a disturbance that you can't understand. These are things that are happening. And if you have any kind of disturbance in your life right now, you want to deal with them, because you will not be sitting in the presence of the Lord while you are being disturbed. And so if you are there and there is such a thing, can you just rise on your feet and stand where you are? I will be calling you here later. You to stand where you are. Any kind of disturbance that is on you, that you're feeling. You know, sometimes we may have such kind of things and we are not sensitive to our body. But the Lord taught me to listen to my body. And so if you can feel there is something that is not normal in your life, there is a weight that is not normal, just stand where you are so that we can pray together. Sister. Thank you. Yes, stand. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place to heal the sick. And so, in the name of Jesus, even as we are in this place, Lord Jesus, I raise a hedge of fire around this sanctuary. I raise a hedge of fire around this sanctuary. And every demon that strayed into this sanctuary today, in the name of Jesus, I want to command you now. You have no place, you have no space, you have no authority in this place. And in the name of Jesus, I want to uproot you. I want to uproot you. Just lay hands where you are. You're feeling that weight or that pain or that disturbance. Just lay hands and may the Lord just heal you now. Yes, yes, that thing that is holding your chest, that thing that is holding your shoulder, fire, 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 Lord Jesus, locate. Let your Holy Spirit, let your angels of healing touch each and every one of them. Touch, yes, that sinuses that is disturbing, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus, and I speak healing now. Receive it now. Jesus, I want to command every infirmity, every affliction that is on these people, I want to command it to come down. I put it under arrest in the name of Jesus, and I declare declare these people free. And before the end of this service, every power of darkness and every damage in their system will have disintegrated because of your power. And I speak healing and restoration in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. You can be seated. We will be calling you later for me to lay hands on you. Praise the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. Do you know that sometimes the devil is an artist? Why is he an artist? He's an artist because he wants to paint pictures of impossibility. And when he paints a picture of impossibility, the reason he paints pictures of impossibility, he paints those pictures so that you may confess impossibility. I'm leaving that to sink, Wanza. I'm leaving that to sink. Why am I saying this? When the devil has painted pictures of impossibility and pictures of hopelessness, and you voice it, you say, this one is useless. This one is impossible. It cannot be done. Once you speak, you've given the devil a legal ground for him to sit on you and to make it impossible. Hello? The Bible tells us in Proverbs 18 verse 21 that the tongue has the power of life and death. Why am I talking about this? Because we have come for Ignite. Praise the Lord. My prayer is that by the end of this conference, as my brother was saying, you will be established and you will continue being established. In other words, the season of being wavery will be gone, and the season of being planted and rooted so that you may grow is come. Bwana asifiwe. Somebody's right knee is being healed even as we are talking. Praise the Lord. And so as I'm talking this, is that there are times that the devil will paint pictures, and he's painting pictures, giving you suggestions. And when he has given you suggestion, what will happen? You take that suggestion and you voice it. The minute you declare it, the minute you put out that word becomes a legal ground for the devil to fight you, to make your situation difficult. Let's say, for example, you don't have money and there is pressure. Praise the Lord. There is pressure all over and everything needs money. And you call yourself. What will I do? I don't know what will happen. Because you don't have money, you call yourself poor, and you've done what? You have accepted the spirit of hopelessness. What will happen? You'll be the one. You'll be attacked, and you'll be finished by what you have spoken. Because your words become the legal ground for the devil to fight you. I want to give you an example. And this happened in my office. Then I realized how heavy this thing is. There's a boy that one time he's been an addict in many things. He was an addict in taking mirror, and sometimes smoking bang, taking cocaine and all that, and he was troubling his dad. His dad was a retired army man. And so his dad was so beaten by his situation, but he had retired and he had gone to the village. So the mother was the one taking care of them in the home. But then this young man was free. The sisters are in college, but him he is free. So one time he came, he brought a girl into their house, and they were having a good time from 10 in the morning up to 4 in the evening. So the mother came back home and found this girl wearing a lasso. And the mother flew into a rage. And she took a broom and she started beating them up. He beat the young man, he ran away, the girl also, he beat them. But as he was beating the young man, she said, "You'll be like Mumu. Hello? You don't know Mumu. So I'm safe. Mumu is a certain young man in that area who walks around aimlessly, picking things, papers, and putting under his armpit, and he looks like he has lost it. Actually, he has lost it. He's not well." And so what happened is that when this young man was brought by the dad to my office, and the mother said, "You'll be as useless as Mumu. I'm taking you somewhere and I will be telling you why. We will be as useless as Mumu." I cast out the spirit of drunkenness, the spirit of addiction. I cast out all those others, but there is one that refused to go. That is the day I also met the prince of the Bakasi. It's not the prince of the Bakasi. The prince of the Bakasi is a demon in charge of the Bakasi, because that is the area I serve. And so he also left. But there is this one that refused to say that one. Autaweza. This is what it was saying. Autaniweza. Stay. You cannot chase us because we have been brought here by the mother. The mother is the one that released the word for our legal ground to stay here. And mother is in his bloodline. This is the son to that mother. Therefore, there is nothing that you can do to us. So, I tried binding. Said, have you ever been told what happened in your ministry, Pastor? You know, when a demon is so confident that it's telling you what happened. So I reached a point, I realized, this one, I must go deeper into the word of God so that I may learn. And the depth that I went, first, before we had started ministering or doing this to this young man, he had been brought by the father to my office. But as they were waiting in the reception, the father had come in to tell me he's doing this and this and this and this, so that when he comes, I start dealing with it. But by the time he came out, the son had run away. Alienda. So he came back to say, "Pastor, ameenda, sasa what we do? I'm leading you somewhere. What was the He said, "Ameenda." Then I asked him, "Ameenda wapi?" "I don't know. I'm sorry for wasting your time, Pastor." But I told him, "Mzee, catch him. What was the My brothers and my sisters, we have authority. Are you listening? We have authority." And so I told him, "Just wait." We laid hands on the ground. matter is where. They are not walking on air, they are walking on earth. That is when he was brought. And so as you were dealing with this spirit, the demon said, mama ndiye alituweka hapa, mama ndiye alitupatia ruhusa, by saying he will be like Mumo. And so Mumo, the spirits that were in Mumo, have come and they have settled. What do you do? And I remembered, you know, the dad was not saved, but he was seated there as these things were talking. I realized, you know, when Rebecca decided that Jacob can only be blessed by Isaac, she will not bless Isaac, Jacob. And she had to disguise Jacob so that he smells and feels like Esau. There was a spiritual principle there. The spiritual principle that the blessing of the father has power. And so I told the father, yes, I say haujaokoka, lakini kuja. I prayed for him for cover, and I told him, now lay hands on your son. So you're a kaibi. Najisu. You know, demons have ways of making you think nothing is possible. And so here he was, as he laid his hand on him, I told him how to pray. He said, I break every parental curse laid on you in the name of Jesus. No, as a father, I break every parental curse raised put on you. The demon started complaining. In other words, we are denying them their legal ground, we are breaking their legal ground, and we are destroying their opportunity and their power to remain in this young man. After that prayer by the father, the demon had no otherwise but to leave. Praise the Lord. Why am I saying this? The Lord warned me today. He warned me that I should not waste time with you. Praise the Lord. He warned me that I should not waste time with you. I need to start dealing with things that are holding people. And this is what he was telling me. You know, this conference is known as Ignite. The theme for this year is a year of the Lord's goodness. Can we say it all together? And abundance. The year of the Lord's goodness and abundance is still connecting. Praise the Lord. When you are let go, when you are released from every kind of bondage, then you start reaching the Lord's goodness and his abundance. And the spirits that were released over this church, and let me tell you, as I'm talking about this, yesterday we talked about three areas. Area number one is that for you to be released, you must be willing to be released. The mindset of bondage, usually this one, the devil makes you think that you are okay and nobody wants you to be renewed. So your mindset needs to be renewed. You don't need to be put in a box. And we read Romans chapter 12. And we also looked at something else, that for you to be released from any kind of yoke and bondage, you must reach a place of tiredness, restlessness, and fed upness, if there is an English like that. You must get tired of your status quo. You must reach a point of saying, enough is enough. And that is needed. And even as you reach this point of feeling enough is enough, you must reach that point also of knowing that has an expiry date. Kufungwa kuna mwisho wake. Bwana asifiwe. And yesterday we read also from the book of Isaiah chapter 49 from verse 24. He said that shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the captives of the righteous be delivered? Those were questions that were asked during Isaiah's time. But Isaiah prophesied and says, but thus says the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. For I will contend with him who contends with you. I will save your children. Save your children. I want to build up on that a bit. But I will feed those who oppress you with their own flesh, and they shall be drunk with their own blood as with sweet wine. All flesh shall know that I, the Lord, am your Savior and your Redeemer, the Mighty One, O Jacob. Praise the Lord. So, as we come to this day, it's good for us to realize that when we are talking about let my people go, there are things that God has seen in his wisdom to give the pastor that revelation of having this let my people go. Why? Because God wants to dig into that foundation, and because foundations can be your arrest, can be your place of arrest. Hello? Foundations can be your place of arrest. If the foundation is not right, you find that your growth is abnormal. The milestones that we say when you are getting children, you say they are delayed milestones. Delayed milestones. Si mnakuaga na vitu kama hizo? Ama tuiongee kwa Kiswahili. Delayed milestone, kama huyu mtoto amekawia kutembea, huyu mtoto amekawia hata kuzungumza, huyu mtoto hata kusoma ni ngumu. He's passing the age of walking, he's passing the age of talking, he's passing the age of even reading, and he's past the age ya kujipeleka kwa choo. When a child is like that, then we can call that child retarded. Hello? And retarded children can be a burden to the parents. A church can also be retarded. Hello? Hello? Tuko pamoja. A church can also be retarded. There are things that when the church is growing, the church achieves those things. There are milestones of a church. But those milestones of a church can be delayed if the foundation is not right. I have several churches in Nairobi that have had such kind of issues. I've been taken to a number of them, and I realize foundations can stagnate, can retard somebody. Your foundation needs to release you, because there are stars in this church, but those stars cannot shine if that foundation is still in the same way. And so as we come to this word, let my people go, so that they may worship me. Bwana sifiwe. When the praise team is worshiping, I remember those days when we were growing up, we come from an Anglican church. An Anglican church is not known for many things. Sisi ni watu wa mtaratara, watu wa order. We are so inclined to keeping order, mpaka tunasahau Roho Mtakatifu anafaa kuwa in our order. And that is what we were. Then the Lord brought us a pastor who released us and who brought people to minister to us. And when they ministered, there was a shaking in our church. About 800 people came to the Lord. After the 800 people came to the Lord, around 80 people were serious with fellowship. But then at the end, we had only 40. And that is the time we were learning to lead praise and worship. We were learning to minister in the power of the Holy Spirit. And it was a good time. And we would pray as praise and worship. Pray over the week that the Lord may give us the right songs and the right ministry so that we may not just sing to entertain, but sing to minister. And so as we were singing, people would be getting healing while we were singing. I was a leader, I was a guitar player, Bwana Sifiwe, tuka retire. So don't ask me anything about that, but we retired, Bwana Sifiwe. And so as we did that, God used us. God used us for that. A church can be retarded. And so after the mission that that pastor released over our lives and over our congregation, and we started growing, the foundations were shaken and things started growing. The future was bright and fire was in the church, but wickedness was also in the church. And let me tell you something. This is a lesson that I learned 2 years ago, that there is Job chapter 1 verse 6. Who can remember what Job chapter 1 verse 6 says? It says, when the children of God gathered, even Satan, the devil, was with them. Job chapter 1 verse 6. This is not verse 6. Yes. One day the angels came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came with them. Kuna kujagwa. Wacha niongeleshe shenga kwa maana nyinyi watu wa mtaa. Kuna kujagwa. The devil does not go to the bar. He comes to church. Why does he come to church? He comes to church to make sure that he makes you sleep, he makes you lack concentration, he makes you lack many things so that things may not work. He has a visa even into the presence of God. He has a visa. You know, when you have a visa, you can move freely around the borders. There was a time we went to Germany and we had the Schengen visa. And so in one day we traveled in 4 countries. We had Italy, we had Rome, we had Italy, we had Austria, we had Switzerland, and we had Germany. And we traveled around. So when the devil has visa, he has visa for this time, and he is always around. Don't come to church and think everybody around is saved. Bwana Sifiwe. And so he will want to fight us. He will want to contend with us. And so this day, this evening, this is what I want to share with you. And in a very short way, then we go into a time of prayer. He says, for his anger is but for a moment, his favor is for life. This is God. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the mornings. Psalm 30 verse 5. The other people say that the darker the night, the nearer the dawn. Victory in life is decided by the last concentrated burst of energy filled with the resolve to win. You must push more. You must fight more. Bwana Sifiwe. Yesterday, the pastor was saying that he was feeling very tired. It's like somebody who has come from a deliverance service. It is true. It is a deliverance service.
So don't lose your focus. Don't forget the goal you set out for. I will not give up. That is the word that you should say. I will not give up. I will not surrender. I will not give in. I must achieve my freedom and my release. Bwana asifiwe. So what is bondage? It's good for us to understand that we have several layers of release that we need to achieve in this church. The layer that we need to achieve, as you who are here, we need to deal with any foundational evils that may have been done in this church. Bwana asifiwe. Any foundational evils. I went to a church, a certain church in Nairobi. It was in Pumwani. That was a church, the first church that was brought into this area, this part of Nairobi, in the beginning. The church was built in 1910. And so in 1910, that church was built. But as it progressed, it reached a point where it had people. There was a pastor, long time ago, that pastor had a bar. And so sometimes, pesa sadaka ikikuja, anaenda kuongeza nao stock. And so some congregation members have had this. And one time one of them just came. He was good. I think he was good in judo. He would have been a good wrestler. He came and took the pastor by the hip. Akamuinua juu. Badala ya kumchapisha chini, alimpeleka mpaka nje akamtupanisha. Tegedi tu. We are talking serious things. So that was it. Then another pastor came, and that pastor was hurt, and he left. Another pastor came, and that pastor also, they had a problem with Jose, and he left. I came into this church. You remember those days when there was a video, a YouTube picture of a pastor who had been caught with, they say they caught him with his pants down. Because he was in a certain lodging somewhere. That pastor, when he fell, the Lord had spoken to us before, about 6 months before, told us that this pastor in particular has fallen. He's broken his back. He's in the bathroom and he cannot walk. So we told the closest person to him to go and tell him. But the closest person to him said, we cannot. That prophecy or that dream or that revelation is too... Hello? Sometimes when you're given a message and you fear to deliver it, actually you become guilty. So we told this man to go and tell the pastor. And the man said, no, I can't. I can't. But we were not close enough to relay the message. And so 6 months later, this thing happened. And the story is all over. And the pastor has to resign or to retire. And what happens? He retires early. And then what happens? I'm the one who speaks, say, told, go and take over. Bwana asifiwe. When you reach such kind of a place, you have to be careful what you say. Because the church is embarrassed, the church is wounded, the church is bleeding, and the church is under a cover of shame. What do you do? So as a new pastor, I had to deal with the foundation. Because here, this church is in Majengo. Majengo. Majengo, you know Majengo? Majengo is in Pumwani. And Pumwani is a place where people from coast were brought to come and rest. But they were brought there, and there was another business that was going on. From Pumwani is where some of these ladies were being taken to go and service the
Kariakops.
Kariako.
Kariakops ndio likageuka ikakuwa Kariako.
Pumuani, pahali pa kupumua, ilikuwa their place of stay. And so prostitution was there. We were brought there for that ministry. And so for the church, which was there, the spirit of immorality was crawling in. The spirit of Islam is crawling in. The spirit of poverty is also crawling in. So if you're ministering there, you needed to know those foundations. Bwana asifiwe. Why am I telling you this? I'm telling you this because in my heart, as I was coming, the Lord was telling me that there is also that kind of a spirit of shame, that kind of a spirit of pain, past pain. And people have come from this church bleeding, and they were wounded, and some of them were crying and things like that. And I had to come and sort out the foundation of crying pastors. The Bishop of Butere, the former Bishop of Butere, Bishop Sande, was a pastor in that church, and he left that church crying because his money had not been paid. He had not been paid for 600,000. Another pastor, the one that was caught, his pants down, he had not even gotten his salary. We had a debt of over 400,000. Then there was another one that we had debts, and here I am. We had to deal with this foundation. As we were dealing with this foundation, something was happening. Every pastor that we managed to pay, actually we would go and negotiate, please, just forgive us. Let us give you this because this is all that we could get. But please, before you go with this check, pray for us. And God released us one after the other. Remember, ignite, let my people go. There was a spirit of poverty that was not going away in that church, because pastors were crying with our names. My brothers and my sisters, I am proud to stand here and tell you that when we paid all those pastors their dues and they prayed for us, some of them wept and knelt in my office saying, I have never seen this. When they wept and prayed for us so that we may be blessed, restoration was in the church. We need restoration. Some dryness is not normal dryness. The spirit of poverty, when we started dealing with it, one time as we were praying, the Lord showed us a vision of rats running out of the church. Tukajua, tumeshinda. So what I'm saying is that when we are dealing with foundations, there are some things that we must deal with. There are some sins that we must confess, not because we committed them, but we did what? But we partake. We are like Daniel repenting for his people in chapter 9. We are like Jeremiah repenting for his people. Nehemiah, repenting. We need to cry to God and destroy the voices. If there was blood that was shed here and is crying about us, may we cry also to God. Because the blood of Jesus, when it is applied on that blood that is crying against us, the blood of Jesus speaks of better things. So we have come to the place of release. But release must only come when we have surrendered. And another thing, as I started, parental curse that is hanging on some of us. Let's just say it's hanging over us. Parental curse may not be your parents speaking. It may be somebody elderly that was offended by you and released a word. Words never die. Words never grow old. My brothers, my sisters, when Joshua stood in Jericho after destroying it, and he said, whoever lays this foundation will lay it at the cost of his firstborn son, and the gates he will put up at the cost of his lastborn son. He did that. Words did not die. Hail, and who was a contractor or a builder, laid the foundation of Jericho. His firstborn died. When he was setting up the gate, finishing the job, his lastborn died. His lastborn is the one that I can remember his name. His name is Wanasifiwe. Words never die. Words spoken over a church, they pull a church down. Wanasifiwe. Priests who are like our fathers. And so whatever happened and we may have entered into, may the Lord help us to deal with that. Wanasifiwe. Foundations must be healed for them to release us. The star of this church must be unveiled for it to shine again, because the glory of God wants to come back in this congregation. Hello? I don't know, because this, what I'm saying is for people who may be older, Wanasifiwe. But whatever the Lord has put in my heart to say today is this, that the Lord may destroy every foundational confusion, every foundational mess that was there, and may the Lord heal this church. May the Lord establish you, and may the Lord continue establishing you, because it is in this season that this must change. Are we together? Are we getting what I'm saying? And so as we come to the Lord, we must release this foundation. You and me at this church. Wanasifiwe. Wewe na mimi ndio kanisa hii. When we go away, the foundation is nothing. The church is just a hall. But we are the church that is here. Wanasifiwe. Is it possible? Hello? Is it possible for us to cry to the Lord for healing? Is it possible for this church to be the fountain of revival in this season? Bonasifiwe. And is it possible for this church wealth to be restored? It is possible. The wealth can be restored. What I'm saying is that I used to sengenya this church when I was passing by a long time. Awatomekalia gold. You cannot have this kind of space in Buruburu, Bwana. Don't take this space for granted. God has blessed you. But you cannot enjoy your blessing. Have you seen homes where there's a curse on the wealth that they have? They have wealth, they have everything, but there is poverty on wealth. Yani tuna mali mingi. Have you seen these families where they have a lot of billions in properties, but they cannot enjoy? They're living poor lives because they're busy fighting. They're busy struggling because a curse is hanging on that. May the Lord release us. Wanasifiwe. I don't know kama nimeingia ndani sana mpaka nikakupoteza kwa network, but what I want is as God may restore this church. I have a love for churches. I have a love for beauty, like the beauty that I can see here. I have a love for churches. I don't care whether it is a church of God or what. I just love beautiful things. Wanasifiwe. Sometimes I dream that one time just build my church. But Wacha tu hiyo ni story nyingine. So this is what I want us to do today. I want us to deal with the foundation. Bwana asifiwe. Are we together? You know where two or three are gathered and they are praying with that deep understanding, then things will happen. I will also pray for cover over you, because the devil hates it when you come out of bondage. The devil hates it when you want people to be free. There was a time I was praying for a lady, and as I was praying for her, the husband has been sending all kinds of demons to fight her, to strangle her in bed, to give her throat cancer, to do many things. And so as I was casting out these things, they said, you, he said, what is happening? You are the one making this lady not to die. We sent somebody to look for you. Say, okay, you sent somebody to look for me. Whom did you send? Said, another shadow, a very powerful one. But what he saw, he said, he will never come after you again. Bwana asifiwe. The enemy hates when you want release. And the release of this church will not be only the release of God's people, it will be the release of your blessings. Because we will not be praying in vain. We will not be releasing things in vain. God will make sure that he who stood in the gap is blessed. He who stood in the gap is multiplied and increased. Bwana asifiwe. So today, even as we go into prayer, I want to just lead us into that prayer. And after leading us into that prayer, I want to also speak against parental curse. You may be here and your parents spoke something negative over your life. And you've been struggling in the area that your parent did that speaking. I remember a boy that the mother just released a word. The grandmother actually. The grandmother released a word on the mother. The mother was a small girl, very simple, very young girl, going to school and feeling happy and is happy with her freedom and everything. But the older sister had gotten a baby, and the baby was so young and struggling. And so the grandmother was brought this baby because the girl who gave birth to this child had found an opportunity to go to America, to go and work. So she went and she was working and sending money to the mother. And the grandmother was the one taking care of this one. And the other girls were around. The other girls had not given birth any yet and all that. But then there is one of her daughters that was still in school, that one time came back from school and she was feeling like wanting to rest. But then the mother said, please take care of the baby. He's crying. She's crying and I think she's wet. And the girl said, like good Nigerian women, wanna see fear. And then she walked away. She didn't want to take care. So the mother said, that is what you can say, or that is what you can do. Yours, you will wipe his battle even in old age. The mother spoke in anger. And she left, finished whatever she was doing, and she came and took care of the baby. Now, this other girl finishes school, and also it happens, you know, there are patterns in some families where every girl must give birth at home before they go, wherever they are going. These are patterns, Meziona. And so here they were. And most of the times you find that their firstborns are always daughters, because they must also give birth at home before they go wherever. So here they were, and she gave birth. She was in school then, but now she has given birth, and she has left her younger sister as the child, because the older sister has given her an opportunity to go to America to work. And so she's working in America, sending very nice clothes, sending money and everything, but the son is almost 10 years old. I think he's 10. And every time he wants to go to the toilet, before he reaches the toilet, kumetoka. He soiled himself, and he soils himself. He's been taken to all kinds of doctors, and they check, and they find that he's just okay, but he still soils himself. Now, what was wrong? Hello? What was wrong? Mama alisema. Hello? And now, the mother said this, and she later retired and she went home. But the girls are dealing with a case here that they've tried to treat and treat and treat and did not work. Later, one of the daughters who are younger is the one that said, hey, there was a time that mom said that you will wipe your child's buttock until old age. So we need to solve this problem. Wana sifiwe. We need to solve this problem. But how do we solve this problem? So they came to the pastor, to my brother Georges, and he prayed with them. It stopped for a while, then it started again. Then he said, kuna kuwaga na referral hospital ya ministry, so I can refer kwa. So they came and they told me the story. I said, okay, kasi uko hapa. I am here. We represent fathers in God. Bwana sifiwe. And so what we did was the younger sister became the mother of the child, because the mother is not here. And the older sister became the grandmother of the child. And the younger sister, we had to lead her into repenting to the mother. Identification. Sin, you identify with the sin of your partner. So she identified with the sin of the mother of this boy, and she asked for forgiveness from the mother. She said, I'm sorry. It was childishness. I didn't mean to do this. And I ask for your forgiveness. Please forgive me. And the older sister, we led her into releasing this younger sister. The boy is standing there, releasing this younger sister. I also cancel the words that I spoke over you. And I'm declaring that now I withdraw every word that the devil has been using as a legal ground to frustrate your son. And after that, we, as the pastors, prayed and released the boy from parental curse. Our father sinned and they are no more, but we bear their iniquities. You remember that verse yesterday? Lamentation chapter 5 verse 7. Bwana sifiwe. Our father sinned and they are no more, but we bear their iniquities. So today, as we go to that, we will do the foundational prayer first, destroying any foundational, repenting the sins that were here. Pray that the Lord may bring healing in this church, pleading the blood of Jesus in this foundation, Bwana sifiwe, and pleading the blood of Jesus to cover the sanctuary, because the cover over this sanctuary may have been switched because of whatever the enemy did here. He may have had a legal ground to cover it. The mark of rejection must be broken. The mark of poverty must be broken.
The mark of confusion at the point of breakthrough must be broken. Bwana asifiwe. As we destroy those covers and destroy any foundational curses that may have been laid because of what happened, then we will now lose our church. And our church will go. Praise the Lord. Let my people go means also let my church go. In other words, my church will be released to serve the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. It will be released to serve the Lord in spirit and in
to help us.
help us
as we repent, the sins of our fathers, the sins of our church, the sins of our elders that were committed in this foundation. My Father, we plead your blood. Foundation. We plead your blood to
silence
any bloodshed that may have been shed in this foundation. Forgive us for the sins that were committed out of ignorance, out of self-love, out of selfishness. Forgive us, Lord. My Father, we need a clean foundation. Forgive us for the pastors that have left our church crying because of wounds. Forgive us for the elders that have been wounded here. Forgive us for taking our pastors for granted. Forgive us for moving into selfishness, into greed, instead of honoring your name. Forgive us for contaminating the foundation of this altar. Forgive us, my Father. Forgive us, my Lord. Forgive us, my Lord. We plead for your mercy. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon our foundation. Have mercy, our Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, forgive us, my God. Forgive us. May we just call upon the Lord. Just call him. Call upon the Lord. Let him forgive us. Forgive us, O God, for the sins we committed. For the sins, Lord Jesus, we did. Forgive us, my Father. Nira talakara basate. Maruta lakura basate da biete. Masuka lakala kuteri osa. Contamination. Oh, Father, we come to your presence. We plead your blood. We plead your blood. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. We will worship you in complete breath. We plead your blood, this Jesus. Jesus, we plead your blood. We plead your blood to cleanse, oh Father, to destroy, oh Father, any foundational improvement in the name of Jesus. Destroy, destroy, destroy every foundational confusion, every foundational sickness, every foundational contamination. Come and take control of power. Father, help us. Help us, Lord. 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 Release, oh Father, your children. Oh Jesus, 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 Jesus. Take back your church. Take back your church. Take the sanctuary. Take back the sanctuary. Take back your people, Lord. Father, remove the veil. Veil on fire in the name of Lord Jesus, the glory of this church, the glory of this altar must be restored. In the name of Jesus, every legal ground that the enemy had, as we confess the sins of our church, Lord, let there be restoration. Let there be healing in our foundation. We plead your blood on each and every corner of this compound. We plead your blood on each and every corner of this church. In the name of Jesus, every power of witchcraft that has found strength because we were weak, we uproot it. Every altar of darkness that was reigning because of our weakness, we cancel its power, we set that altar on fire, we destroy and uproot it in the name of Jesus. The spirit of discord, we uproot you and we evict you in the name of Jesus. The spirit of poverty, we uproot you, we destroy you, and we set you out in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of the Holy Spirit consume discord, consume poverty, consume confusion, consume disrespect in the name of Jesus. Today, we raise a new altar. A new altar of revival. We raise a new altar of the Lord's mercy. We raise a new altar of power that demons will not reign in our church. Demons will not reign in our church. Oh Jesus, shake the foundations of darkness. Shake the foundations of darkness. In the name of Jesus, lose your fire. Burn every wicked power. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, destroy. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Oh, Jesus, thank you. I want to ask Pastor to come. Pastor Jessica, I want us to stand together with you. Bwana Sifiwe. As we stand with him, you, my brother, my sister, some of you have been suffering from spoken words, curses that were released on you. Maybe with your parents, and maybe they have been strengthened by some of the things that were spoken in this church. Because demons do something known as a collab. They collaborate with each other to destroy. And so if somebody saw a curse that was hanging over you, and you have walked into a church where there were words that were spoken against people, that this church will never have peace. I've had that word spoken in my spirit. That this church will never have peace and it will never grow. Whoever spoke it in bitterness, may the Lord release this church. May the Lord release, because of the blood of Jesus, may the Lord have mercy upon us. And this is what I want us to do. Can you just lay your hands on your head? Just lay your hands on your head. And together, as I'm holding the hands of your senior pastor, he is blessed of the Lord, and the Lord has allowed him to do this. And so can we say over you, just hold your hands on your head. Can you say, we are saying in this way, child of God, every negative word, every curse that is hanging on you, every word of backwardness and barrenness and frustration. frustration, at the point of breakthrough that has been hanging over you as a curse, as a father in God, I cancel the power of that word. I cancel the power of that word. And in the name of Jesus, I destroy altars of darkness that have been destroying your breakthrough, that has been destroying your womb, that has been destroying your progress. As I'm standing here in the office of a priest, I want to destroy that. I want to overrule every parental curse over your life in the name of Jesus. From today, I change your destiny. I change your destiny. I declare that you are blessed. I declare that you are chosen. I declare that your ministry will be blessed. The time to favor you has come. The time to have mercy on you has come. May the Lord cover you with his mercy. May you receive release today. In the name of Jesus. Your environment
has changed.
In the name of Jesus. May the light shine on you. May you be released from every curse word. In the name of Jesus.
From whoever it is.
In the name of Jesus.
Holy Spirit, we thank you.
Consume every negative thing.
Consume in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you.
Just hold your garments like this. Just hold your shirt as if you're fighting with yourself. Just hold it and say with me, Lord Jesus. Every garment of rejection. In my life. Catch fire now. Be destroyed now. I'm no longer a reject. In the name of Jesus. Catch fire now. In the name of Jesus.
Catch fire.
Jesus, thank you. Thank you. Oh, Jesus, thank you. For every curse that was spoken over you, the Lord has broken it.
Hallelujah.
And for every curse that was spoken over this church, it shall not prosper. It has changed.
Hallelujah.
May the destiny of this church change.
Amen.
May the star of this church be released.
Amen.
May the people that reign and come into this church be people who are blessed.
Amen.
People who are multiplied.
Amen.
In favor.
Amen.
May you increase.
Amen.
May the spirit of poverty be broken.
Amen.
May the Lord release millions in this church.
Amen.
May the Lord release favor in this church.
Amen.
May the Lord release increase in these people.
Amen.
In the mighty name of
Jesus Christ.
May your ministry be smooth.
Amen.
Because of the anointing of the Lord.
Amen.
And from today,
amen.
The curse of poverty,
yes.
The curse of confusion,
yes.
The curse of discord,
yes.
Is broken.
Broken.
Is broken.
Broken.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Happen, there is nothing flowing in your life.
life. That thing is removed now. Bwana asifiwe. And any confusion that comes whenever people, your divine helpers, want to call you, that confusion is broken. Because your divine helpers must remember you. Bwana asifiwe. And I want to declare this. I want to declare this. That whatever was blocking you, it does not matter which part of hell that demon comes from. The power of the Lord Jesus is locating it and destroying it. And may the Lord release your jobs. May the Lord release your businesses. May the Lord release your opportunities. May the Lord release your finances. May the Lord release your divine helpers to locate you. May the Lord release your marriage in the name of Jesus. Because favor is come. And may the Lord cover you with his mercy. May the Lord cover you with his mercy. When mercy is covering you, the conditions under mercy are favorable for your healing, for your breakthrough, for your blessing. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.
In Jesus' name. I just want to ask us kindly to package our offerings as I call upon the ushers. Let's just package our offering kindly. Usher, tusaidia haraka kidogo. And then I also want to announce that after this, there is tea, so we can have tea as we leave. Thanks so much, man of God. God bless you so much. So, amen. I'll just ask us, for the sake of time, we just give our offerings, and then I will call Reverend Wabi to come and conclude for us with a word of prayer. Bwana asifiwe. So, to singoje song, let's just be free to just walk and drop our offering for the sake of time. And then Reverend Wabi will come after this and conclude.
I believe we'll be blessed. Hallelujah. The Nana na feel released because spirit yake. Hello. Hallelujah.
Let us rise up for our prayer.
Tomorrow we are here at 4 p.m. Tomorrow we are again here at 4 p.m. It will be better than today. Bwana asifiwe. The latter glory will be better than the former glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. So tomorrow, let's meet here at 4 p.m. Invite your friends, and God will bless you so much. After Reverend has prayed, they will stay there as we go home. Shalom. God bless you.
Let us believe and pray. Our Father in heaven, the master of our life, the creator of our souls, we give you praise, we worship you. Because you gave us an opportunity to be here this evening. We have fellowshipped in your word. We have heard your voice.
We give praise to your holy name and we exalt you because it was worthy being here today. As we depart to go back to our houses, we have confidence and favor upon our hearts to know that you care for us so much, that you bless us and you bless our families, that you meet us at our point of need and continue to shine upon our path as we continue to walk in your salvation. We are grateful, dear Father. We don't take it for granted. We give you praise and we worship you from your sanctuary. We honor you and we lift your name high, because besides thee, there is none to be worshipped. May your blessings rise upon each and every one of us. And may you have an opportunity to come again and listen to your word. Before us, there is a cup of tea. We pray that the fellowship of the cup of tea and any other accompaniments shall be blessed by your Holy Spirit and even your word. And as we partake of it, we may all glorify your name for the provision. And now, we pray blessings upon your people. May you shine upon them. May you favor them during the night, during the day. And may all their doors open for the glory of your holy name. And none of them shall lack for the time that they spend here. But they shall glorify your name and sing a new song as they bless you in their journey of salvation. Because we have prayed, believing and trusting in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, He is our Lord and Savior. Amen. God bless you.